Thank you for joining me today to learn more about how Amazon DevOps Guru, a machine learning powered service from AWS, helping developers and operators automatically detect anomalies and improve application availability. My name is Shivan Singh, and I'm a Principal Solutions Architect here at AWS and a DevOps Guru Ambassador. In this episode, I'm going to show you how Amazon DevOps Guru for RDS, a new ML-powered capability, can automatically detect and diagnose database performance and operational issues, enabling you to resolve bottlenecks in minutes rather than days. But let's first understand, what is Amazon DevOps Guru? DevOps Guru is a fully managed service that uses machine learning informed by years of experience from Amazon.com and AWS Operational Excellence. These models can identify anomalous application behaviors such as increased latency, error rates, and resource constraints, and surface critical issues that could cause potential outages or service disruptions. It does not require you to have any machine learning expertise to use it. Once you sign up for the service, it automatically starts monitoring the data and metrics to understand your application's behavior. DevOps Guru reduces noise and helps focus on the highest severity issues with detailed insights to provide a quick MTTR. DevOps Guru for RDS is a new capability in DevOps Guru that uses machine learning and anomaly detection to look for unusual and problematic performance events in your Amazon Aurora MySQL compatible edition and Amazon Aurora PostgreSQL compatible edition. When it finds one, it performs analysis on the anomaly to determine what kind of conditions are contributing to it. Some of the conditions that DevOps Guru for RDS can highlight are database wait states, also known as wait events, that are creating bottlenecks for users. For any anomalous wait state, DevOps Guru for RDS also identifies SQLs that are likely contributing to the problem, as well as memory and IO. When DevOps Guru for RDS detects a performance bottleneck or operational issues, it displays its findings in the DevOps Guru console and sends notifications via AWS services such as Amazon EventBridge and Amazon Simple Notification Service, also called SNS, enabling you to automatically manage and take real-time action before they become customer-impacting outages. It has no manual step, and you don't need ML expertise or deep database expertise. Now let's look at how Amazon DevOps Guru for RDS works. It all starts with performance insights. The database tuning metric and telemetry tools for RDS and Aurora. DevOps Guru for RDS relies on this data and only works if you have performance insights enabled on your Aurora clusters. DevOps Guru for RDS ingests numeric metric only, never any customer SQL commands or other sensitive data. It particularly monitors the database load metrics for anomalies, comparing historical baselines to current activity to pinpoint unusual behavior. One of the optimizations DevOps Guru for RDS has made for database workloads is to account for seasonality. In many database workloads, there are regular periodic spikes of activity from batch jobs, ETL, reporting, and other scheduled tasks. DevOps Guru for RDS only highlights anomalies that are not periodic and that occur outside of the regular course of normal database activity. Once an anomaly is detected, DevOps Guru for RDS performs analysis on the metric that make up the anomaly, making note of the most prevalent wait states, SQL commands, and other metrics that coincide with the anomaly. A rule-based algorithm processes the result and generates simple, straightforward explanations and recommendations. DevOps Guru for RDS sends the basic anomaly information, including severity, timeframe, and resource IDs to the main DevOps Guru service and console. DevOps Guru has the ability to send SNS events and integrates any database anomalies into the big picture of your full application stack. Here in the DevOps Guru console is where customers usually first find out about a database anomaly. Anytime DevOps Guru for RDS detects an anomaly in an Aurora cluster, the DevOps Guru console will highlight it and direct you to the DevOps Guru for RDS detail page for more information on the anomaly. On the detail page, DevOps Guru for RDS displays the analysis results, providing the context necessary to understand what is contributing to the database issue, and also the results of the analysis that point you to the best next steps for resolving the problem. With that, let's go to the demo and see the DevOps Guru for RDS in action. I'm here on the AWS console, and I have few database instances in my AWS account. You can go to AWS console and search for RDS and click databases. You can see all the database instances I have. Now, in RDS, we have something known as Amazon RDS Performance Insights. Performance Insights is a database performance dashboard designed to help you quickly assess performance on the relational database workloads. One of the core metrics of DevOps Guru for RDS measure is the database load. Simply stated, it is a count of how many database sessions are active at any given time. A session is just a connection to the database. But DevOps Guru for RDS don't just count all sessions. It only counts active ones, that is, connections for which the database is in the middle of fulfilling a request. So that means it's counting sessions that are not idle, but instead active in a call. It turns out this counts especially if you average it over 1 minute, 5 minute, 15 minute, or 1 hour is a very accurate measure of how stressed a database is. Performance Insights collect this count once per second. So I'll select one of my database instance and I can see health of my database here. This health dashboard is designed to detect and visualize database health. I can further drill down by expanding the visualization here and see the detailed visualizations. Just looking at this visualization, you can see that there is something wrong. There is an increase in the database load. The number of CPUs are 2, but the database load has increased from 20 to 500. What that translates into practice is that there are 2 workers on the database that are doing the work, but there are almost 500 sessions that want to do the work, which means vast majority of them are waiting. That affects user experience and it represents poor database health. While Performance Insights help provide details on the database health through a visual representation, it does not alert or alarm the engineers about the issue. That's where DevOps Guru comes into play. DevOps Guru not only detects these kind of issues, but also provides diagnosis and next steps in terms of recommendations on how to solve those issues. To see those issues, let's go to DevOps Guru console. Here on the dashboard, DevOps Guru shows the overall system health of the entire stack of your application. On the Insights page, you can see various anomalies detected by DevOps Guru. Here you can see that DevOps Guru has detected anomalies in my Aurora database. Clicking on these anomalies, you can see the detailed overview of that anomaly on the Insight Details page. It shows various metrics related to the database, along with the visualizations. To see the detailed analysis of the issue, I'll click View Analysis, and it will take you to the detailed analysis page where it shows you the database name, engine name, anomaly type, anomaly start time, and the duration for which the anomaly lasted. It also gives you a quick description of what happened with your database in simple to understand text. To scroll down, you can see here, it's the same graph which we saw in the RDS Database Performance Insights page, but it provides more details than that. It highlights the detected anomaly in red for which the customer was alerted via SNS. It highlights the start and end time as anomaly boundaries to easily visualize the duration of the anomaly. It shows the statistical analysis of the problem. For example, in this case, it shows that the size of the spike is significantly higher, that is almost 500 times higher than the typical database load. This statistics is important because it's not just based on the typical threshold value. Instead, it's based on the entire database load analysis. And therefore, DevOps Guru for RDS only alerts users if there is a spike which is highly unusual compared to typical database load. In addition, DevOps Guru for RDS also provide detailed analysis and recommendations to what you can do about the issue. For example, it's showing here that there is a high load of wait event for the RDS database instance. It shows the exact metric name, Aurora lock thread slot mutex, related to the high load. And if you click the metric name, it provides the meaning of that metric in simple terms, which does not require database expertise to understand. Not only that, there is also a link to the detailed documentation page related to that specific metric, which tells you what are some of the actions you can take to resolve the database problem and the reasoning behind why DevOps Guru recommends these actions. It's very important to note here that unlike commercial databases, it's very difficult to find detailed troubleshooting documentation for open source database engines. It either doesn't exist at all or it's very scarce in details. This is where DevOps Guru for RDS helps reduce time to resolution from days to minutes and providing detailed troubleshooting documentation. Let's look into another use case. This is an Amazon Aurora Postgres database. From this visualization, you can see that there is an unusual spike in database load. But this one is different than the previous one. In this case, it's waiting for CPU wait event. And once again, we provide the details about what a CPU wait event means, the troubleshooting documentation for the issue, the SQL queries, and the reasoning behind why Amazon DevOps Guru think its unusual activity is a problem with the database. In addition, we are also doing something else here. DevOps Guru is also looking at the system overall and answering the question whether CPU resource has also been overrun during the time of the problem. And in this case, it is. When you click the related metric, you can see these visualizations where you see that the CPU has really been exhausted and it had effect on the database performance. First, you see that there is a running task metric that went really high during the time of the problem, and therefore correlated to the problem itself. Another metric that people typically monitor is CPU utilization for monitoring CPU exhaustion. And you can see it's also running very high at around 100% utilization at all the time during the database problem duration. The way Amazon DevOps Guru recognizes that this is a CPU exhaustion issue is by correlating multiple metrics and collecting signals that are pointing all in the same direction. In this case, there are two very strong signals that are coming from the operating system metrics, that is running task and CPU utilization. And there's also a very strong signal coming from the database load as well, because CPU wait event has taken a very significant chunk of the entire load. In this case, it's almost 100%. We provide the reasoning as why Amazon DevOps Guru think it's a problem, and some of the recommendations on troubleshooting the issue. There are a few other use cases where Amazon DevOps Guru for RDS can detect issues. For example, due to database memory issue. In this case, Amazon DevOps Guru detected a problem with the database memory, and it was derived by the strong signals it received from multiple metrics like out of memory kills, database memory usage, and number of database connections, all signaling in the same direction during the time of the database problem. So that's DevOps Guru for RDS and how you can use it to detect, diagnose, and remediate a wide variety of database-related issues in Amazon RDS. I hope this episode gave you a good sense about how DevOps Guru applies AI and ML into your development and operations workflows to improve your database performance. Don't forget to watch the other DevOps Guru episodes, which also deep dives into other use cases. Thanks for watching.